Hi, this is Lee Brower. Just finished the Philadelphia Rock and Roll Half Marathon. And this is number 6 for us. Last spring, trying to figure out how I could contribute more for WACKY and bring awareness to young adults living with cancer and the legacy that our son Nick gave us, we decided we'd run a marathon every month, a half marathon, and culminate in January with the Goofy. And the Goofy is kind of insane, really. I don't know why I've committed to it, but once you commit to something, you have to follow through. And as I was running, it was a very emotional day for me today because I thought about Nick, and a tremendous amount of emotion came into me as I thought about that young man and all that he has done to build awareness for young adults living with cancer, his courage and the warrior that was with him. And I had the opportunity to see that warrior rise up and come out of him. I've seen it come out of those that love him, that warrior inside, how it surfaces. But that was the warrior that was in that young man. He had the courage to be able to overcome the toughest of challenges, and it's made my life better, it's made our family better. Somebody the other day said to us, man, that must have tested your faith. I said, no, not at all. And actually said it to Lori, and Lori said, not one second. What it did was made our faith stronger. I want to invite you to join with me. Make a pledge and become WACKY. You can get WACKY pin and WACKY shirts, and you can become part of the WACKY Nation, if you will. If you'll just join what we're doing, you can come run with us, create your own events, or just support. Pledge a few pennies, a dollar or something, for every mile that we run on this campaign that'll be culminated in January. This is important, and you can make a difference. Please support me in this. Thank you very much.
The race following the slacker was a race in American Fort Canyon, and my hamstring was really bad, and I wasn't willing to risk pounding it outside and then doing something that would not allow me to be able to run in the Dallas race, which would have been up in September, and this would have been July, and I didn't want to take a chance of not maintaining it. So Paul carried Flat Lee along with him, which was on a big giant popsicle stick, had a life-size picture of my head. And so he ran the entire race with in front. And if he would have thought about it, as he crossed the finish line, he would have held me back this way. But he actually, when he crossed the finish line, had a picture of me right in front of him. So I actually beat him on the race. But if he'd have thought about it, he'd have put me head down and pointed me behind him as he ran across the finish line. So
I have to tell you, that was the most annoying race I ran because Lee kept telling me, go faster, beat that person, come on, go faster, you're slow, go faster. Well, the whole way, and so that was, I'll tell you what, boy, I was ready to give up Flat Lee to back to Big Lee. Lee and David both mocked me for my running focus and getting my game face on. If you see any pictures of me running, it's like serious deal. Dave, on the other hand, is smiling and waving at everybody as he goes by, and I've got, look to kill. But I determined that this was just going to be a fun race, just thinking, gosh, it would be fun if we were together. I mean, this was one you wanted to enjoy as a group. And running down, all of a sudden I ran into Lee. They're on Main Street for Disney World, with the Cinderella's castle, ahead of us. And throughout the event, there was places you could stop to get pictures with different Disney characters. Buzz Lightyear and Cinderella but we would run real fast between the characters so we could stop and get our picture taken with the characters. And gosh, throughout this whole race, they had that, but, I guess one of the great memories for me was running with Lee and then stopping to get our picture taken. And just, again, enjoying that experience that we worked so hard to get to, but enjoying that together and having that fun time.
For the half marathons leading up to the Goofy, the 10 half marathons, I always came in last.
Not just last. He would come in and we'd be ice cold by the time he would cross. And we'd run back to try and see him, and he's got a big grin and he's waving to people. And
he thought he was on a float.
And in the meantime, my sweat's frozen on me, and I'm like, where is this guy?
I thought they were always in front of me, and they were, they ended up being behind me. And so it was kind of an added feature of beating both Paul and Lee.
Well, I'm sure that's, that was emotionally gratifying.
So how does this work?
You keep track of how many feet each participant climbs. And then they're trying to, they have a goal of what they're trying to reach, but I don't know what it is.
So each location has a certain number of feet that they...
Yeah, so they call it a route. So each route represents so many feet. And so then we just keep track and then tally it up at the end.
And how many sites are there today?
Oh, they're all over the country. But whoever wins this area gets a brand new pair of Riva sunglasses. And then they have to, the minimum they have to pay is $25 to come and participate.
I see.
And then they get a t-shirt.
Cool.
When I decided to do that, I really didn't have the, I felt guilty asking anybody else to do it with me. You know what I mean? Because I too felt it like it was a little bit crazy. And so when I mentioned it to Dave, Dave got this look on his face and is like, why? Why are you doing that? Dave says, I don't want to do that. I said, Dave, you know, you don't have to do that. He says, yeah, I do. If you're doing it, I have to do it. You know? And I'm like, no, you don't. I'm not saying that. But since you're doing it, I have to do it. I said, great, you know. And so then he calls me up and he goes, Paul's going to do it too. And I said, really? That's great.
I think the friendship that we built, you know, we're business partners and we're coworkers. That the friendships that we built are very important to me. Also, again, I'm constantly thinking about the people that go through much more than me, that have cancer, that don't get to do this. And one of the things that keeps me going is that, you know, if I can do it, anybody can. Being able to say that I did it. Thinking at the beginning that I couldn't do it.
If you recall, we get down towards the end this, you know, had the opportunity, and Paul and I were getting our picture taken with Tigger, some giant puppet with Tigger, and at the 20-mile mark, I jump off and my shoelace lassoed a stake sticking up out of the ground that was holding the puppet in place, so I do a face plant and break my arm and cut myself up a little bloody and tear my knee up. And it's kind of like that's the way life is too. You know, you're moving along and you think you're there. You only got 6 miles to go. You're enjoying yourself. And then out of nowhere comes the unexpected, the bang. And at that point, you have two ways to react to it. You know, I mean, you could become the victim and really kind of fall into that space. And fortunately enough that the arm was broken. I mean, the elbow was broken, but it wasn't like sticking out through the skin or that kind of a thing. And, but, you know, nonetheless, it wasn't enough to even slow us down, I don't think. I mean, it didn't slow us down, Paul, did it?
Not much.
I mean, once we got figured out what was going on, we just took off and kept going. And so really, it's right at the core of everything that we do. It's the core of what we believe in. It's at the core of having health and strength around families. Our families were there cheering us as we came in and support us. One of the things I appreciated the most was the strength that my wife gave me during that time, and the strength of family, and being able to go back and participate in that. The tweets that I got from my grandkids, the different things that happened as a result of it, I think strengthened that. The experience itself, the relationships, the networks that we got involved with, the learning that happened, the increased capability that came as a result of it, the foundations that we're able to honor and support, and scholarships that we're able to give as a result of this. Who knows the little ripples that went out because of the sacrifices that were made by other people, whether they be in Dallas or whether they were in Philadelphia or where, no matter where they were, that either made the difference by writing a check, sending some letters of support, being there running themselves, you know, and the effect that it had on their family and the effect that it had on other people in the community. Who knows where all these little ripples went out?
Thank you, baby. How sweet it is. And thank you, baby.
The Honored Heroes run in Dallas. One of the really neat things about that race as well was how many wacky shirts we had running. We can talk about this maybe if we've got some more time, but the opportunity to run as a team and to run for a cause and to be there together. And gosh, we probably had 80. I'm not sure, Dave, maybe you know the exact number, but
yeah, it was about 80.
About 80 people running, and it was just great as you'd run, and it was kind of an out and back course, so you ran out to a point and then turned around and came back, so you saw people when they were running back on the course, and to see all those wacky shirts was just cool. I mean, it's just wonderful, and we give each other high fives as we pass each other, and just had a great experience. So that really was a neat run.
It was fun because for a number of reasons. One, the little four-year-old girl had been training herself for quite some time, had her own little plastic training watch that she would wear, and she would get her mom, and because she did a, they had a one-mile kids run, and so she would get her mom. If her mom forgot to train, she said, "Mom, we forgot to train." Didn't matter how late at night, she'd make her mom go out, and they'd run around the block, and so to see her in the little shirt and a lot of little kids like that running, it gave us an opportunity to really see some things that are really meaningful in this life, and so I'm really grateful for that, grateful for their support and all that it meant. When you're living with someone that's got cancer and you're watching how they handle it, and the caregivers and those that love them and care about them, the one thing that your eyes get open to is you start seeing the real true human spirit. You start seeing heroes, you know. It makes me wonder how many heroes I've missed seeing in my life. We felt like it would be really nice if we could, in Nick's honor, come up with a Nick's Wacky Warriors Courage Award, and really kind of honor somebody that's shown extreme courage, whether it's a caregiver or somebody that's a survivor of cancer. So we gave out our first Wacky Warriors Courage Award at this event, and it went to a young mother, a young wife who had lost her husband and to cancer, and her daughter. And it was a real pleasure and a real honor to be able to present that. We came up with a beautiful sculpture, an original sculpture that we call Emergence, and it's something that we see ourselves doing in the future, is to honor heroes.